So when you deal with the homeopathy, it is too important. This is the all cases, generally these 5 cases which I have selected, those were last 5 months, 2-3 months. It was the start of March, just in this month. There was all of a sudden rainy weather there. A female patient, 30 years, was brought to me with fever, with severe joint pains, with severe restlessness continuously moving in the OPD. Asked her to sit down, to which she denied. She said since night she never slept due to the pains and stiffness. She tried to sleep, which aggravated her joint pains. Feel little bit better by moving about. And there was a history of getting wet in rains on an earlier day. There was fever blister. There were fever blisters present around her mouth. Her tongue found to be a typical triangular red tip and indented. So again, remedy is everyone knows. Rustox is the remedy. How to give the Rustox? Question is how to give. So remedy is clear. And this was very, what you observe in practice, you see the weather changes and you see the human reactions. How much study Hahnemann have done? Question or rather, how he has looked towards each and everything. You observe the patient and you get a typical rust patient and cloudy weather, rainy weather and red triangular tip at that same time. Otherwise there is no red triangular tip. Patient gets up and on typical fever blisters during damp weather, rainy weather, not in rest of the weathers. Why this is so? This is too important to understand. This which you can get in your practice. These are the things which are necessary to understand. So remedy everyone was knowing, Rustox, again the same thing. High potency in a few doses, not too long. Rustox 10, 3 doses, along with the bicombination 11 for 5 days. Rustox being an acute remedy. What one should think, you open your Borix Matramedica or if you have Kent's repertory and at the end there is a remedy relationship is given. Open that remedy relationship and see the action of Rustox. How many days does it act? There is only 1 to 7 days action is there, Rustox. Bryonia is subacute. It is 7 days to 20 days, 21 days, I think so. So that is subacute remedy. Depending upon that action, you can understand how much depth that remedy is at. Aconite, 1 day. Allium sepa, 1 to 7 days. So Rustox is acute in pace. Your patient is also in acute in pace. Rustox comes in acute. Yesterday he was better, today he is suffering. Acute. So your remedy should have that same pace. The way patient enters, you must enter into the patient in the similar manner. Then it works. You cannot treat that with calcarea. Calcarea is like this. So it will not match the pace. The pace should match. Your remedy should match that pace. Then patient gets the result. So you have to understand exactly the pace of the remedy. So Rustox is a good remedy. So high potency because susceptibility is too high. Patient was in a panic state, in a restless way, joint pains. So he was affecting more internally than susceptibility is high, potency is high, repetition is less. You don't have to go on repeating again and again. So patient recovered within 2-3 days. He was completely better. Let's just understand what is there in the Rustox. Rustox is a very important remedy in your practice. You get it up and on in your practice. Because number of times nowadays we get the Rustox weather. Earlier there were only 4 months. Now it is whole year we get the Rustox weather again and again. Number of times the weather changes, fluctuations are there, sometimes sudden rains, and you get Rustox weather very common. So you should be attentive enough to catch that weather. So adapted to the persons of rheumatic diathesis. So in Rushtox, rheumatic diathesis is very important. If fever is there, rheumatism is associated. Even common cold is there, rheumatism is associated. If patient is suffering from cough, he is having the joint pains. If he is having fever, he is having the joint pains. So rheumatic diathesis, bad effects of getting wet, especially after being overheated. Pains as if bones were scraped with the knife, worse after midnight and in wet rainy weather. Affected parts are sore to touch. Lameness, stiffness and pain on first moving after rest or on getting up in the morning. So first movement, the aggravation, it is only because of the stiffness. The stiffness is characteristic of rheumatism. The parts become stiff. So if he is stiffened, he used to move this like this earlier, and gradually when it becomes free, then it becomes the stiffness. That's why the pain is at the start of movement in Rushtox because of stiffness. Great restlessness, this is too important. Great restlessness, anxiety and apprehension, like aconite and arsenic, cannot remain in bed, must change the position, often to obtain the relief from the pain. From mental anxiety, it is arsenic. If patient is mentally restless and he is moving here and there, it is arsenic. If you have to reduce his anxiety, give the arsenic. But for the pain to settle, it is the Rushtox. Physical, at the physical level, it is Rushtox. At a mental level, to release the restlessness, arsenic is the good remedy. Restless cannot stay long in one position. Corners of the mouth are ulcerated. The fever blisters around the mouth and on cheek. Another remedy given in bracket is Natremium. But in Natremium, recurrent fever blisters, not specifically during damp weather, in Natremur, you get the fever blisters up and on whenever they exert and they suffer from it. So that is typical, generally happens in summer also, then it is Natremur. Tongue is dry, tongue is sore, red, cracked. Triangular red tip takes the imprints of teeth. This is too important. Indented tongue. So, Chelidonium, Podophyllum, Mercurius, these are the remedies where you get these imprints on the teeth. Very typically, Rushtox is one of them. But in Rushtox, it is not indented, but red triangular teeth is there. In Podophyllum, it is indented along with the flabby tongue. It is big, like a large base like a Mercurius. In Chelidonium, it is because of the liver affections basically. So, we have learned four cases, we will enter into another case in the same day the case was there. This case was on the same day, but having exactly the different variations. In the same damp weather, female patient 40 years was brought to me with fever with severe whole spine backache and in a very prostrated state. Prostration, what is prostrate? It is too much exhausted, the torpor state. She was not able to sit on chair and she lay down on the examination table directly. She was not sitting in front of me, she lay down on the examination table. She was in a drowsy state, not wishing to answer my questions and lied completely in a quiet state. Her parents told that she was not consumed anything since yesterday, not even water. She was having very severe bursting cervico-occipital headache. There was a headache which was there in this area. This was very difficult. And she only told me that she was getting chill from cold back. In Marathi, she has told, Pati Kodun Thandir. This is very typical, the language with which she has used. And this was the case. Same day, same time, same weather. It was damp weather. So, remedy is very clear. Yes, it is the Jalsemium. Very good. Jalsemium. Why Jalsemium? Dull, dizzy, drowsy. Okay. Jalsemium, 1 mg. 3 doses were given and again same by combination 11 TDS for 5 days. And patient was within 2 days, the patient was very well. It recovered very fast. So,
what is one thing? One day only it 200
200 only thing is that when you expect a very fast result and patient is in an acute state, give one in, it acts very fast. It increases the pace. When you increase the potency, it increases penetration. For that purpose, higher the potency is very useful in susceptible states, highly susceptible states. Patient is completely in calcium state. Why not to go for high? This was very fast. George Vitulkas says this very nicely. If you read his book, Essence, that is the three volumes. Classical talks on homeopathy, talks on classical homeopathy. Three volumes are there. He has, in the first case only, he has mentioned about that. It was a typical phosphorus case, and he asked that to the mother of that child who was having the fever and who was not getting fever recovered since last 1-2 months. Patient was admitted and he was sure about the phosphorus. The patient's mother asked, sir, how much time will it require to get better? He asked, when do you want? If you want it today, give 10 m phosphorus. If you want it tomorrow, you give the phosphorus 1 m. He has very nicely explained that, and that aspect of understanding the potencies was very clear with him. He is very good clinician. So this is what I have learned from the different people. This is how I learned. So if you go on increasing the potency, it penetrates very fast. But you should be damn sure. If you are not sure, go for low. That is very important. So, gelsinium 1M 3 doses associated with bicombination 11, we'll learn little bit about the gelsinium. Gelsinium headache is beginning in cervical spine. This is too important. This is patient always complains there is a pain in back side of the head, in the cervical region or occipital region. Pain extend over the head causing bursting sensation in forehead and eyeballs. Two more remedies which are mentioned over there, the sanguinary and silicea. Both remedies are having the headache starts from occiput, it settles over one eye, right side head eye is sanguinary, one of the eye is silicea, and only on left eye is the swygia. This is very difficult with these three remedies. So begins in same way but semilateral. They have to be quiet, to be let alone, does not wish to speak or have anyone near. Even to the persons, if the person be silent, they don't want to get disturbed. They want in one position, like Ignatia. But in Ignatia, it is different. The pathology is different. Ignatia, it is because of some mental trauma, and that's why they don't want to get disturbed. Here, it is because of physical illness, they don't want to get disturbed. Chill without thirst, especially along the spine, running up and down. The back in rapid, wave-like succession from sacrum to occiput. And this is very characteristic of the gelsinium. The pain is running from up and down in the back. And patient talks in that sense. When they talks in Marathi, they talks always in the incentives, particular incentives. This is very typical with the gelsinium. Aggravation damp weather and before a thunderstorm. This is too important regarding the gelsinium. One more thing which is gelsinium is headache better by profuse urination. That is one more feature one should not forget, that is characteristic of this remedy. So these are the things one has to look for. Then one more thing which we have to learn in today's session. Homeopathic physician must be able to perceive the direction of winds daily. We have learned when we learned the geography. In childhood, eastern winds, north winds, south winds, west winds. I was not knowing that geography will be useful for us in future. but it helped in only way. We have the remedies for that. Only thing is that we have to perceive the winds. How you can perceive? Which winds? If you want to keep your health okay, you have to go outside, either cycling, either running, either walking, and you can find it out from where you are getting the winds on your body. If drops of winds are there, from which side you can get it. And if you don't want to be maintain the health and you want to remain in a naksamika phase, sitting in one place, there is one more way you can learn. Open your Google and find it out, the weather and the winds. You can get the winds, which types of winds are blowing in your area. These are also useful because there is this helps number of times. This is very important. What type of? You have to understand the cause and effects, because that cause plus effects gives you individualization. You can match them very easily and you can get, yes, remedy is this, very confirmed. So, in our Materia Medica, we have this. In our Alinsky notes, you can get this. This is from Alinsky notes. Causes, drops of winds and remedy. East winds, Calcarea fossa and Serpia, these are two remedies. You have learned in geography. पूर्वी करुण्य वारे वारे ईशान्य वारे नैऋत्य वारे पश्चिमी वारे दक्षिण वारे वी हैव लर्नड इट दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वेस्ट विंड्स एकोनाइट नॉर्थ विंड एकोनाइट साउथ विंड इट इज यूप्रेशिया एंड इफिकिया वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट यू कैन मैच देम डायरेक्टली यू कैन मैच द रेमेडी द कॉज एंड इफेक्ट्स सो पेशेंट कम्स टू यू All of a sudden, doctor, what has happened? I don't know. I was all right and I went on bicycle or I went on motorcycle to some such and such place. I got dropped of air and suddenly I started getting severe headache and body and fever and twitching, and please give me some medicine. He's in an acute phase. Within 1 hour he developed the symptomatology. And then you ask where you have it. You must know where, in which direction he is. He goes to the west, because he goes to the north. If you are sitting in Sangam there, you ask him in which direction you have gone to, whether you have gone to Nasik or whether you have gone to Akol. Nasik is on north, Akol is on west. You must find it out, and he get that draft and he developed that. It might be opponent. So, logic you have to utilize. When you are using the homeopathy or you have to do the homeopathy, you have to learn number of things at a time. These are the things which guides you in acutes very easily. So, this one thing one should not forget, what you have to catch in the cases. This is too important for you. This is one more important